So I'm back working on this thing. Remove the clamps. The bridge isn't moving this time. I'm not really sure if I'm going to bother trying to reinstall the screws, mainly because of the crazy glue job on the inlays. I don't think I can pop them out. I think I'm just going to wreck it. And I think if you watched before, you could see that one of them just ripped right through the countersink. But it's not moving now. Shame about the finish. I'm going to try and do something. I did a little bit of a retouch there. Maybe if I polish it up. Try a little bit of clear lacquer. I did a little bit of black. And, you know. Yeah, baby, I like this guy. He's a good guy. He's the guy that owns that other Joe Satriani Ibanez thing that I set up tuned to drop C or whatever it was. So, yeah, I'm going to try and fix that up a little bit. See what we can do. And, you know, just to try and understand what happened here is that because it was glued to the lacquer, all this sort of where it tore apart, it never had a chance because when the bridge lifted, it pulled the lacquer up with it. So even, you know, I mean, I'm not even going to blame the last guy that tried to fix it, but the lifted finish and stuff, there's nothing you could do because it was glued to the finish. Even after I cut all around with a razor blade to try and release it cleanly, it still bubbled because that was already there. And then we had the bad repair on top of it. And I don't know if it's model cement or crazy glue or some sort of acrylic cement or something they jammed in there. It was pretty bad. Well, if all these skid marks weren't all over the thing or whatever they did, maybe I can polish that out, but I don't know. Guy that always said not to worry about it. Gee whiz. Pretty messed up. Okay, back to this. Big high fret at the body joint. So we've been told. But now that this is fixed, let's fix that. Let's fix her up. Well, I got this stuff. This is from that company we hate. Or I shouldn't say it. Hate is a very powerful word. These are polishing cloths from Stumac. And, you know, hopefully I won't make a bigger mess than's already there. There's that always that possibility, I mean, that's... Actually, I think I'm using the wrong side of the thing. Yeah, there you go, R's head. I'm so preoccupied with making the video, I'm just fucking up. Oh, I can smell. I gotta buff this on the wheel now. Look what I've done. I've created fucking haze mode here. I got rid of most of those scratches, though. This'll be fine. It's gonna look great. But this is an easy fix for a tight spot. And then I can just, yeah, I got it all figured out. She's going to look beautiful. You watch. I can't always make them perfect, but I can make them better. So I buffed off most of that ugly, scratchy stuff. And once strings are on it, we're going to oil the... bridge, and let's get the strings back on and figure out what's going on with this thing playability wise, because that's really what the guy bought it for. He got a good deal, and I'm gonna fix it for him dirt cheap, and he's gonna have a cool guitar to bang around on that didn't cost him a lot of money. So sometimes it works, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Okay, so I got the one here, and I'm shaking the living piss out of this, and the sprayer still, you pump once, gooch twice, Oh, there we go. Okay, anyway, I'm going to use it on this poor fucked up Gibson. Oh, did I say the F word? Sorry. Yeah, I should try. I'm going to go right on the guitar. Oh, look, she worked. It's the workout pumper. So, yeah, it sucks about the frickin' marks in the front of this. Well, it's shiny anyway. Put those strings back on it and see how badly it's screwed up. Well, the bridge didn't pop off. And I have no fear that it's gonna either. I'm still gonna polish it up more, just because I'm that kind of guy. Of course, I blew the high E string, which had like 800 kinks in it. But the, let's just get this going here. The neck, it ain't very straight right now, but we still got a fret buzz thing. Where'd my rock and roller go? Here it is. Right at the body joint. So I'll use the old strings. It's enough string tension to, for that to present itself, but I got to get the right Allen wrench. Straighten out the neck. I'll try and polish the front for the guy. It's a shame that this is gooched like that, but what the hell. I think it's going to play pretty good. The string action looks really good, actually. It's just, considering the way everything was all busted up. Bing bong, back in a minute. So today I'm shaving the bridge saddle, but I'm just shaving the high E side. And I'm doing it the old-fashioned way with a piece of sandpaper on the flat workbench, and I'm going at it. And that's what I'm doing. So give me a minute, and then we'll put the dead old strings on. I still got to measure what string gauge those suckers are. And put this back in it, and away we go. So I found the right truss rod wrench. It is metric. Welcome to Ibanez land. Straighten out the neck best I can. Now we're looking at this body joint fret. It's got to go. Okay, so here we go. Sometimes when I'm making a video, I feel like it's a frickin' Twilight Zone. The one where they just keep doing the same thing over and over again. This is the cutoff little piece of a mill file. And what I'm going to do with great expertise, and actually, I'm just in that sort of a mood. I'm gonna, this guitar hasn't had enough shit kicking. I don't need to make any more marks in it, so I'm just gonna tape that guy off. Woohoo! And then I'm gonna shave some material off it. Must be a fun ride. And then we're going to remove the tape. Voila. Where's my thing? Seems to have got it on the treble side, but not on the fatty side. Not on the fat string side of things. Yeah. So I heard a joke today. I don't even know if it was a joke. I shouldn't tell it. It was bad. Okay, let's give this another go. Ah, shit. See, I don't charge enough materials. Like, that's got to be, like, you know, 2 cents worth of tape. I should put that on the invoice. See, that's it. No more Rocky Rolly. Cool. So now I got to crown it. Hold on. Okay, so I got the narrow guy here. This must be like a rock and roll camera ride, I'm sure. Actually, maybe the camera's wiggling with the guitar. That's the 150, pretty nifty. Let's just check that. The bugger about this is sometimes when it gets string tension on it, it appears again, and you have to, you know, take the string tension off, take actually more material off the fret and anticipate the string tension. Okay, so that's 150. Let's flop over to 300. Now the funny part about this is this fret's well, I'll polish it. It'll be polished better than the other frets, so that you get a free, like, fret polishing out of this one. Cool. Yeah, that's gonna sail a lot better.
Okay, so the frets are all cleaned up. What do I want to do next? Condition the fretboard. I guess we can lose the old strings. I'm not going to do any more setup work with those. We've corrected the problem as far as I'm concerned. Let's bottle this one up soon enough. Oh, I'm going to polish that some more. I won't sleep right. So let's get a little final never dull on the frets. You know, you could never tell I was hacking at that fret there to look at it. We really didn't take a lot off. It wasn't the end of the world. You can't believe how much linseed oil is just drank up, you know, and if you zip back to earlier shots of the neck, you'll just see how dry it is. This is just the same way it needs. I'm gonna, you know, give a little more oil there when I'm done futzing here, but everything seems to be pretty good. Oh, I gotta string to peel out of there, and that's what's going to happen. New strings. I'm pretty sure I got the action where it wants to be. I just somehow think the guy wants to put light strings on it. It's not going to work right, but he can try that on his own. He's getting 12s because that's what I got. Away we go. Time for strings. Prosper Bronze. 12 to something or other. Let's get them on.
Oh no,
Ooh, ah, ooh.
I can just tell by putting the first string on. This thing's gonna play great. The string action just looks fantastic already. It doesn't look like, you know, the snaky ladder frickin' fretboard. So I got the two E strings on. I want to check out, you know, sort of get an eyeball where we're at, because we did shave the saddle. Shave my saddle. It sounds like a porn. And I sort of almost a little tight. Oh, 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 we gotta get all the strings on it to be sure. Let's look down the neck again. Neck looks straight. Wish me luck. Let's get the rest of the strings on it. We're hoping that the tightness on the that string is going to come out of there when all the other strings are yanking on that spot we hate. So on and so forth, and forth on and so forth. Nice close up of my fat gut. See? More than one bad fret spoils the bunch. I didn't think I'd be out of it. So, I want to let the whole guitar rest now. We've just re-glued the bridge, we put strings on it, we've truss rod adjustment. I just want to make sure I don't have to do any more fret work, so we just let it sit on the bench overnight now. Son of a bitch. Cheers, folks.